we're acting silly.
Look at us being silly. Oh, that's scary. That's almost scary.
Tim's headbanging to hemispheres.
To hemispheres. Hey. To hemispheres, gentlemen. To hemispheres.
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 I'm sorry. Cheers. No. To Cygnus X-1 Book II.
Oh, we were talking about the album, Tim.
We're talking about the album Hemispheres. Who are you?
Well, okay. I'm fine. Okay.
Right. Hemispheres. Were y'all glad to listen to it?
Hey, Shayne, do you like breathing air? Bom, 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 bom.
Here, why don't I start? Because clearly I'm the brains of this operation. So okay.
It's hard to play the music and talk at the same time. So yes, Jay, thank you. Take us home.
So hemispheres.
Bring us home.
This is the studio album by Rush that we have that's not the sixth that we discussed, but it's their sixth studio album. And there's only how many songs? Four songs in the album? One, two,
four songs.
Three, four, yeah. But a couple long ones. I really didn't know much about the album before we started listening to it. I'd never listened to Cygnus X-1 before.
Really?
Nah, I never listened to it that much. And I certainly never listened to Circumstances. And of course trees and La Villa Strangiato is sort of the only two that I was really extremely familiar with. But overall, this album as a whole, pretty good.
Yeah. You're talking about the album, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
I wanted to be sure
because you'd brought up something else.
It's true. Yes.
Yeah.
See, I was just thinking of this, how if you start and listening to the 2112 album, and you get through, you're like, oh man, that was so great. You listen to Hemispheres and you have that same feeling, but at the same time to me, besides all of Cygnus X-1 Book II, side one, and then with Stances the Trees, but you end it with La Villa Strangiato. I'm almost exhausted thinking about all the playing and Getty's high-pitched, singing that he's having to do on this album.
Yeah.
It's just, it's like running that marathon, which we've already discussed. Bow, dew, dew. And not only running it, but the great feeling that you won the marathon, just boom. And that's the way Hemispheres is to me, because there's a lot of kick-ass playing on that album.
I'm pretty much in agreement with you. And I think the reason we made it to the finish line is because we never turned our back on the monster.
That's good advice. Never turn your back on a monster.
Yeah. No. So they'll get you.
They'll get you every time.
Every time.
Then, Jay, would you say, so then you appreciate Circumstances and Cygnus X-1 Book II more than you did before our analysis?
I do. I absolutely. X1 has now. That's become up there amongst some of the Rush songs that I've listened to. I really love that song, and then going back and hearing book one, The Voyage, but then Circumstances. I never really listened to that song before, and I listened to it several times, and as a matter of fact, I just listened to it today, and I reached a new conclusion about well a a conclusion about it. And my conclusion is this. Still not my favorite.
Not your favorite.
I still just don't really, I think it's fine. It's just okay for me. And I'm sorry, Tim, but I just, you know, it's not that I don't like the song. It's that I just don't love it.
So your opinions of it have not changed much,
Well, not much. I appreciate it more. I don't like completely disregard it now.
Gotcha.
In fact, I will listen to it every time if it's playing somewhere. Okay. Like,
I'll take that.
I will listen to it every time it comes on. I'll put it on.
Okay. I'm sorry. I must have zoned out. Like, and I've forgotten things. What song are we talking about right now? Wow. Circumstances. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Jay. Uh-oh.
Here it comes.
I'm going to say this one time and one time only.
He's going to say it a lot, Jay. Get ready.
Yeah, I know.
You're wrong.
Oh, that is not what I expected him to say.
Tim, can we just agree to disagree?
No, not if you're wrong.
Well, no.
Yeah.
I mean, look, I agree that you're wrong. So why don't you just, agree?
Because that never happens. No, okay. And I get it.
You know what? And you know
hey,
what?
Hey, what if they took the little, the little keyboard solo with the bells out? That was out of the song.
I don't think it would make that much of a difference.
Really?
Honestly. Yeah. But you know what? I will go back and I will move past that part of the song and listen to it. And I will let you know.
Okay.
But again.
Oh, boy.
I don't love it, but I won't skip it if that helps. So I think that's a win for that song.
Tim, how about you? Do you appreciate any songs more than you did before we discussed it?
I don't know, because I've never had any ill feelings towards any of the songs.
What did Hemispheres do to you?
Well, I mean,
yeah, okay.
You know, I mean, I like it as much as I ever did, and more than that.
And I guess so. There's really nothing to change your mind about.
No.
I'm kind of the same. I liked it.
If anything, the thing that I took away from revisiting Hemispheres is learning something that, you know, I never thought of before with the trees and how preaching socialism it is. I always just thought it was a bunch of trees that didn't like each other and, were coming to blows about it. But,
Yeah, I mean, trees blowing each other, basically, is what you're saying.
In the wind, the leaves. What are you talking about?
What? Jay? I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Just is this thing on?
Now, Tim, I feel a little bad because I didn't go nearly as deep into the lyrics for Cygnus X-1 Book II, Hemispheres.
Yes.
As I could have. Same with the trees. There was a lot there, and I feel like I could have helped you appreciate those songs even more than you already do if you had had my wisdom to boost you.
Shayne, I'm going to say this one time and one time only.
Okay.
He's going to say it several times.
You're wrong.
Oh. Oh, look.
Good point.
They're moving pictures.
So I want to mention something here on Cygnus X-1 Book II Hemispheres. Actually had a favorite. I really love that song, by the way, and I actually have a favorite movement of that song, which is the Bringer of Balance, and that's the one where Getty sings, and he kind of sounds very Pink Floydish. his voice. It's got
we will call you Cygnus, the god of balance. You shall be with the vocal parts going on there. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, the very atmospheric thing, yeah. Like you might hear in a Pink Floyd.
I have
awareness. But I have no shape.
That's the part. That's the part I'm talking about. Yes. Yes.
That's what I want to do. I want to go to a bar. I want to go to a bar and sing that.
Yes.
I want to get a whole bar of people singing that.
We have passed into Olympus as was told the tales of old
to the city. Hey!
Go Cowboys.
Oh, then he ruins it.
Sorry. But I have to say, though, you know, my opinion of trees did not change. Like, to your point, I still love trees to the way you guys, you know, you basically, you guys are saying you don't love it better. You love it just as much as you did.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. I don't know if I'm right. I'm not sure I can appreciate it anymore than what I do.
Well, you know,
I mean, because musically, I always listen to it intensely, musically.
Right.
Yeah.
So the songs, okay, let's forget about the album as a whole, but the songs individually, is there anything that you appreciate more than you might not have before, or something you might have heard differently, or something you might not have noticed as much before?
No. I listened to this album. I mean, I've listened to this album in its entirety several seasons.
So you know it like the back. You basically know it like the back of your hand.
Dear God, I never saw that before.
Yes, Tim.
Yeah, no, I get it.
You have two hands. That's your left hand. You probably never use that one.
Okay, so what's your favorite song? What's your favorite song on this album?
Well, La Via Strangiato is top six overall for me. So we should analyze that one sometime.
We should analyze it a third time.
Okay, so La Vila on this album, La Vila is number one, all the other are number two.
Okay, so here's the way I feel about it. And Tim, I'm not trying to make you mad here, but on this album, La Via Strangiato is number one, and all the rest of them are number two.
Okay.
Oh.
I disagree with you, but okay.
Wait, you... okay.
Don't impress me.
I think that the trees is number two, and the rest are number one.
The trees isn't. Oh, you're mean! Wow, I love the trees. The trees is my.
I've been skipping the trees like I used to.
Trees is still my number two. It would have been my number one.
That'd be a good round, an episode of Skippers, the Rush.
And I would say Cygnus X-1 Book II is my number three. But there's only four songs on the album, so.
I don't think I noticed. I don't think I noticed before the cohesion of the four songs in their the theme of, I guess, that like the balance or transcending the differences. I never noticed that before until we.
Okay, here he goes talking about transcending differences again.
I love saying transcending. Try it. It's fun.
Well, you know what? It's just that's fine. Hey, yeah. Tim, let's. It's okay. Our friend here, Shayne, he's a trans
sender
transcender.
Yeah, he's a transcender.
Yeah, he sends
Shayne,
out trans.
Shayne, do you love saying transcending, or are you just coming up with things to say?
I'm just coming up with things to say.
He blew it.
I ruined the gag.
We golly, we set him up.
I love saying transcender, Tim.
Do you say transcender? Do you really love saying transcender? Or are you just naming
transcender?
He's still not getting it, Jay.
That's okay. You know what? We don't all have to be entertaining.
No.
Just you, Tim. Just to you.
Obviously.
You're obviously the brains of this operation.
He's the brains, sweetheart.
Oh, Star Wars. Thank you.
Hey, welcome. Welcome.
I love it.
Thank you.
I love it. I love Star Wars.
Yeah, I wish Rush would have written an album called Star Wars.
Oh, me too. That would have been awesome.
Why?
Can you imagine what Geddy, Alex, and Neil would do to the Cantina song?
It would have been absolute greatness.
Geddy hops on the keyboard. Alex hits the famous Hemispheres chord.
Yes. Wait, I think it would have been.
Which chord, Tim?
The chord he uses on the album Hemispheres.
That one that he uses at the very beginning of Cygnus X-1 Book II.
Prelude. Yes.
All right. Well, I think it's fun. I'm glad we decided to do this. I'm glad that you two picked Hemispheres to do second. This is all fun. All right. Any final thoughts before Tim takes us to the clearing at the end of the path?
I have a question, and this may be an unfair question. Let's say if we were doing which, by the way, I loved the head to head competition of songs on the Rush discussion.
Yeah,
that we did with them. That was so much fun. So if we had to put them up against Power Windows, which do you like better? Now I know this is still yours. That would make two second favorite albums, but just these two albums, head to head, which do you like better?
Tim.
Tim's
putting him on the spot again.
Are your eyes bleeding? Your ears?
Yes. There's blood coming out of my ears and my toes.
Gone all stigmata on us.
He's gone all stigmata. You say
stigmata, I say stigmata.
You say, yeah. So,
hey, let's just call the whole thing off.
Good point.
Good suggestion.
Yeah, okay. I don't think I could. I would have to agree with Tim on that one. I would. I couldn't pick one.
Because of different aspects. Technically playing the instruments, it's La Vila Strong, it's the album Hemispheres.
Right.
Yeah.
The sound of Geddy's vocals, I go to Power Windows. I like his singing better on those songs. And again, it would be great if it was 1985 and the three of them said, guys, this is what we're doing. We're going to do everything we've done so far, okay, with that year's recording technology, processing, blah, 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 blah. You leave Terry Broon as the producer and see what, you know, those older songs would sound like. Still, you know, you're not changing the playing was done or the singing, but just it'd be interesting on something like that. But I mean,
look, I wouldn't
if there's an album you're going to get stoned to, it's Hemispheres.
Okay. I would think 2112,
but we're not talking about 2112. Right. We're talking about those, Power Windows two. And right. Hemispheres.
Honestly, I'm going to have to say that, you know, Power Windows has always had a soft spot for that album. But man, Hemispheres is just something musically. It is the better album. But I have to also agree with you, Tim, as far as vocally, I like Geddy's singing. on Power Windows. So I'm going to say tie.
Tie. I'm going to change my vote because I had a thought. La Via Strangiato is top six of all Rush songs for me. So I think I'd have to go with Hemispheres so that I can hear.
Yeah, you kind of have to. Yeah. And
Well, hang on a second. You don't necessarily have to do that.
I do.
La Vila could be your most favorite. I mean, in your top six, it could be your number one favorite song. But yeah, overall for the album, maybe you like all the other songs from Power Windows better than Cygnus X-1 Book II and Circumstances in the Trees. You know,
let's put it this way. If you were going to be stuck on a desert island and you could only pick one album to take with you to the desert island, Tim is wrong.
For me, that would be Hemispheres.
Nope. Tim is wrong. There wasn't a question. Tim is wrong.
To me, it would be Power Windows. Why?
Tell us.
There's four more songs on Power Windows.
The extra songs.
Okay. That is a very logical way to look at that.
Right. Yes.
Tim just doesn't want to go without a motion detector.
I mean, album lengthwise, time wise, it may be the exact same, but there's four more songs.
True. Good point. Yes.
Hemispheres is 36 minutes. And Power Windows is 44 minutes. So,
well, that's the four extra songs.
All right. Well, there you go.
You get like 60 extra minutes or some math. I don't know.
Math is hard.
Or some math. I don't know.
Transcendence.
Speaking of transcendence, I think Tim has finally transitioned into that picture.
Yeah.
Or transcended.
Tim, can you come out of the darkness and help us bring this episode to a close?
He's back.
Thank you very much, Dublin, Ireland.